Well, every parent has a list of hopes and dreams for their child, but when your child is born with a disability, that list may require some revision. Well, Amy Bell has switched gears and is ready to take a look at parenting a child with special needs. And Amy, what has got you thinking about this topic off the top?
You know, I think parenting is just an overwhelming endeavor filled with chaos and doubt and daily fear about your child's well-being. But if you're the parent to a child with a disability of any kind, you might feel those battles more keenly than me and fears that are far different than mine. Through absolutely no effort of my own, I've been blessed with two remarkably ordinary children. But for parents with more extraordinary children who have a disability and needs unique to them, parenting can be a time filled with confusing lows and incredibly rewarding highs.
Sure. And the minute, of course, that your kids are born, or even before they're born, I suppose, you start dreaming of their potential greatness. You also start worrying terribly about their futures.
Yes.
And when your child is born with a disability, I mean, it must be difficult initially anyway to wrap your head around that new reality. And so where do parents even begin to figure out what is, you know, suddenly going to be the new normal?
Yeah, I mean, that's a whole mindset. From the parents I spoke with, it seems the early days, so just either before or right after a diagnosis, it's just so overwhelming. Honestly, we've come a long way since days of institutionalizing and refusing to acknowledge children born with any disabilities, but there's still a lot of information and assistance that can be really difficult to either access or even just to navigate. Wait lists for treatments and rehab can be long, and government funding can be scarce. Private care is expensive, and it's not always as well-informed as it is well-intentioned.
Right.
One organization that tries to help from infancy all the way to adulthood is the Developmental Disabilities Association, which was actually started in the 50s by a small group of parents in Richmond and Vancouver. I spoke with Executive Director Alanna Hendren about their many programs available to people of all ages and all abilities. But I was most struck about her personal thoughts regarding parents who are at ground zero of a diagnosis.
So when they do have a baby that's not perfect, of course, they're extremely upset and afraid. And a lot of times, the best thing they can do is talk to other families who've been in that situation and who've gone through it. So infant development really tries to ease families' worries and ensure that the families see opportunities and see that there are possibilities.
And it's not just the kids, obviously, who need help. Mm-hmm. I mean, where are parents turning for support?
I think a really great resource for any parent, but especially for those who are raising these children with disabilities, it's people that have been through a similar experience. They say it takes a village after all, and this applies here. White Rock resident Leslie Stoneham wasn't expecting to give birth to a child with Down syndrome 31 years ago. When she had Kira in 1988, she was provided with outdated info and was still presented with the option of giving her child up for adoption in 1988.
Oh my gosh.
But she knew instantly that she was going to raise Kira just as she'd been raising her older daughter, Lindsay. And that meant with love, sometimes very tough love, compassion, and especially joy. So I asked her what she'd say to a new parent with a child with special needs.
You're a person first. That's all I can say. That's what's helped me in this wonderful voyage that Kira has taken me on, because she's been my teacher. She's taught me to be a better person, to be less judgmental. So that's what Kira has brought to our lives, is to make us better people, more patient, less judgmental, and just love more.
And you hear that a lot about how the parents are the ones who have grown the most.
Yeah, learned so much from these children.
I would imagine that it's hard not to, shelter or protect or do everything you can for a child with disabilities. I mean, just to try to make life as easy as possible for them.
Yeah.
Does that actually help?
I think it's very normal urge to do anything for your children. Sometimes we know we can help them or make things better, and it's just too tempting not to. I can tie a shoe with my eyes closed, so just let me add her. Lucia Arega is a Bowen Island resident, and she's also the mother to a brilliant, boisterous 6-year-old girl named Maya. So Maya was born with ADCY5-related dyskinesia, which is an incredibly rare genetic disorder that causes uncontrolled movements and greatly affects Maya's mobility. Yes, she needs a lot of assistance from her family, friends, and community, and she always will. But Lucia is very conscious of the fact that while Maya does face many challenges, so do all kids. And part of what will ultimately help Maya is her parents knowing when to take that step back.
Most kids at that age will ask for help far before they need it. So I think it's just human nature. And a lot of what we do with kids is encourage them to build the confidence in knowing that they can do things for themselves. They just have to, you know, try a different way or keep trying and persevere. Give her that same opportunity to prove for herself and prove to herself that she can do it. So it's that fine line of staying close but not too close.
Parents such as Leslie and Lucia just want their children to be seen as people first, regardless of any needs that they might have, that they not be defined by their disabilities, and that everyone realizes just how lucky they are to have these children in their lives. They have the same desires and hopes for their kids, happiness, companionship, accomplishments, that any parent would have. There's nothing special about that. Everyone I spoke with overwhelmingly said kids are the most open to their children. They're the ones who naturally tap into their empathy and acceptance. They're the ones who help without even questioning it. Maya's mom described children as innately kind, which is lovely, and I firmly believe that. But somewhere along the line, we forget that natural acceptance, and we focus too much on what people are lacking. So as parents, we need to work hard to not only instill, but keep that kindness in our kids at any age, because this will only continue to make a more inclusive community for everyone. And that is ultimately what benefits those with disabilities and those without. All too often, we view people with special needs and disabilities by what they can't do. So instead of celebrating all that they are capable of and capable of becoming.
Amy Bell, thank you.
Thank you.